Hello everyone, it's Shane Kanto, your Wasteland reviewer, and here's my last film to catch up on, and wow, I saw My Little Pony the movie, because I literally see anything, and I'm not a brony, I've never watched this show, I do have a good friend Dave, who does really enjoy this show, and really into it. Going into this, I'm just like, I hope this is a fun animated film, because not to go too off on too big of a tangent, which I try my best in these videos, but in outside of these videos, I go off on tons of tangents. You can ask any of my tutors that I supervise. Anyway, I'm going to digress on that tangent, but animation has been really disappointing this year. Basically, the Lego Batman movie is the only animated film that I've seen this year that I actually thought was great. And honestly even deserves to be nominated for Best Animated Feature. So I'm really concerned about what the hell is getting nominated this year. Honestly, Coco, please. So Coco and Lego Batman, I don't even know if they'll nominate Lego Batman. They didn't even nominate the Lego movie that should have won Best Animated Feature, but it's probably going to be tons of foreign animated films that I'm going to need to catch up on because I'm so disappointed about animation this year. And My Little Pony, it was fine. It was fine. It wasn't awful. I didn't regret seeing it. But there's some fun parts. There's other parts that I'm like, please stop talking. But I'm going to start with Jason Theisen, who directed this film. This movie's all over the place. There's so much stuff going on in this film, trying to introduce too much, and somebody who doesn't watch the show getting thrown right in, and then so many other characters getting introduced in this film. It's just like, it was not balanced. This movie is always moving, and it has kid pace. It's blowing through this movie. So honestly, that was probably for the best, and I thought that worked for the film. And it's just really silly and honestly melodramatic, because it's like really obnoxious, like heavy-handed, like hammering you on the head with these themes of friendship and stuff like that. And I'm guessing like that's the point of the show, but I'm like, okay, I get it. This is really for kids. I get it. You don't need to like lay it on so thick. And there were some affecting moments in this film, and a lot of it actually centraled around Tempest, who is Emily Blunt's character. I actually really liked her in this film, really liked her scenes, but there are some more powerful scenes that you really felt for these characters in this film. I wish you could have felt more connected to the characters, but, and then Anthony D. Money did the cinematography of this film, which I thought was interesting that an animated film had a cinematographer. The animation is very fun and very vibrant. Like, holy crap, like, this is how bright this film is. And I thought it was animated in a way that made sense for the film, so I'm going to give it credit for that. But this film, written by, there's like 7 people who get like story credits, writing credits, screenplay, blah, 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 blah. It's so scattered and unfocused, and you're bouncing around so much to try to, like, and it's so overly simplistic, the plot, but it's just so all over the place, it just complicates things. And then Tempest is like really the only really strong character that I cared about. I didn't really feel connected to any of the main ponies, and they all felt very indescript and just like they could have been interchangeable, except one has a southern accent for some reason and lassos people. But everyone else is just like really high-pitched voices and like screaming and blah, 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 all the time. I'm like, please stop. And it was a little much for me, if you couldn't tell. And honestly, I didn't think this was funny really at all. And the dialogue was really obnoxious. And there's a few moments that really do hit home, and like I mentioned, it really does centers around Tempest as a character. And the only other character I thought was really enjoyable was the Storm King, voiced by Liev Schreiber, and I thought he was funny. He didn't have a whole lot of depth, but he was an enjoyable character. And when you're really looking at the music, Daniel Ingram did the music for this film, and the music was fine, and the songs, because this is a musical, there's a couple of songs that I did really enjoy, especially Emily Blunt's song, which she sang as Tempest. it had a bit of an edge to it and really stuck out in the film for me, and I thought that was really well done. Emily Blunt and Liev Schreiber, Emily Blunt's intense and emotive in her vocal performance, and Liev Schreiber just having so much fun. That was just enjoyable to watch him. But honestly, all the main ponies, they all sounded so similar together, and just like, can't really tell the difference between some of you. And this had a ridiculous cast. And Taye Diggs and Zoe Saldana and Kristen Chenoweth, and it's just like, and Sia, which you have Gazelle from Zootopia that felt at least a little bit like infused into the film. This felt so heavy-handed. It's like, we wanted to have a pop music star do a song for the film, so let's make a pony look just like Sia and throw her in here. It's like, okay. And my final thoughts, the it factor of this film, it's very creative world that I thought was wasted in this film. And it wasn't terrible, and it wasn't good, which is why I'm gonna give My Little Pony the movie a C minus.